Welcome to the lectures. Welcome to survey 2. In previous class, we were discussing about the tachometric survey. We started with the discussion on tachometric survey. We saw the introduction about tachometric survey as well as we discussed the different methods of tachometric survey. What are the different methods, or to say, what are the different systems of tachometric survey? We have seen, we just see them, and after that, we discussed in detail the fixed hair method of tachometric survey. And that we see the three cases under the fixed hair method, that is one for horizontal angle of hair case 1, or for horizontal side case 2, for one angle for both the angle of elevation, and then case 3 for both the angle of depression. For that, we have discussed the fixed hair method in the previous lecture. In today's lecture, we will learn the tangential method of tachometric survey. In this method, that is the tangential method of tachometric survey, the stereo hairs mainly are not used to bisect this staff for observation. In this, we have the two vanes. One is the upper vane and another one is the lower vane. Generally, these two vanes are kept, the distance between these two vanes are kept constant, and the cross hairs of these vanes are bisected on the staffs, and corresponding to that, the vertical angles are recorded. So these methods are generally preferred when the telescope is not equipped with these stereo diaphragms. And in the so in that situation, if you want to find out the distance and elevations of different points, then what to do then? Because in fixed hair method, the telescope must be fitted with the stereo diaphragm. But in our situation, suppose in a case the telescope is not provided with the stereo diaphragm, then what to do? In that situation, we will generally prefer this tangential method of tachometry. So in this this method, what we are seeing in here, the stereo hairs are not used to bisect the staff. The distance between the two vanes are kept constant. So we know the staff intercept corresponding to vanes, the upper vane and lower vane. We take the staff reading, so the staff intercept will be known, and corresponding to each vane, we will record the vertical angles. So with the help of them, we will try to find out the distance and elevation. Here in this also, we will discuss the three cases. One will be for both the angle for both the angles are angle of elevation, and both the angles are the angle of depression, and last one, that one angle is angle of elevation and another angle is angle of depression. So out of all these three, we will start with the case one, that is both the angles are angle of elevation. This is the horizontal plane of collimation. These are the two vanes, upper vane as well as lower vane. This is the height patch of the instrument. Let's see, this is the point. Let's say this is the point B. And this is the point A. Distance between point A and point B is the D. Let's call this point as K. So these are the two vanes, upper vane and lower vane. So this will be the staff intercept. Okay. And we will call this value of this lower vane from the HPC. This will be called as the B. Well, let's call this value from this the place where the staff is kept, from this point to the distance or the height of this lower vane, let's call this as a R. We will keep R. Let's call this point as a point O, this as a P, this point, this as a Q, this point we are calling it, this as a B, this as a K. So here we will try to we will try to write the formulas for calculating distance and elevations. So We can see from this triangle, the triangle OPNK. This is the right angle triangle. The triangle from triangle OPK. The OPK is a right angle triangle. Okay. First of all, let's just give the angles. Let's call this the angle to this upper line from the horizontal plane of collimation. This is the theta 1, and the angle to this lower line from the horizontal plane of collimation, let's call this is the theta 2. So in this triangle, the OPK, the triangle OPK is the right angle triangle. In this one triangle, this OPNK. In this, if I write the tan theta 1, it will be the tan theta 1 equals to this distance divided by this distance. This will be perpendicular divided by the base. So this the distance will be, this total distance means it will be the PK divided by this OK. So this PK, I can get this P to K, this I can get if I add this S of intercept as well as this V. If I take the solution of these two, I will get the PK, so I will write S plus V divided by this OK, this is nothing but the D. So from here, I will get the one equation that S plus V equals to D tan theta 1. Let's call this as equation number 1. Now, from this triangle, now we have analyzed triangle OPK. Now, analyze the triangle OQNK. The triangle OQNK, this is also a right angle triangle. So, from triangle OQK, the tan theta 2 will be this triangle, this triangle tan theta 2, this will be this distance V divided by D. Because of what it will be, this will be QK divided by OK. Divided by OK. So this will be nothing but this QK. QK is nothing but the V. So V divided by D. So from there, it will be the equation number 2, that is V equals to D tan theta 2. That's all. This is equation number 2. So we got the two equations. One is V plus S plus V, or to say the V plus S equals to D tan theta 1, and another equation is D equals to D tan theta 2. So now I'm interested to find out the D. What we can do from here, we can apply some operations. That is what, if I subtract the equation number 2 from equation number 1, that is equation number 1 minus equation number 2, then we will get cancel and I'll get the S, and here I'll get the expression in terms of D. So I'll apply. From equation 1 minus equation number 2, what will be S plus V minus V. From this S plus V minus V, this will be D tan theta 1 minus D tan theta 2. Here I can see that this V2 will get cancelled. Well, here I can take the D common, so it will be S equals to so if I want to write the formula in terms of D, then D equals to, it will be S divided by, this term will be taken to the bottom, the to denominator, that is N theta 1 minus N theta 2. Station B from this station, from the point where the station is at, that distance will be the D, it is S divided by tan theta 1 minus tan theta 2. Here, if suppose the RL of this HPC is known, here this is given the equation that RL of this point, RL of HPC, that is horizontal plane of collimation, is known to us, and we are interested to find the RL of this point to be, then what we have to do? The RL of HPC is known to us, and we want to reach at this position. We are at this position, this is given to us. the arc of this point is given to us and we want to find out the arc of this quotient. What we can do? Now from here, if I add this value of b to the HPC, if I add this value, then I'll reach at this quotient. After that, but here I reach at this position, but I'm interested to reach at this position. What I will do, if I subtract the value of R, I reach at this position. So if R of HPC is not, then R of HPC plus V minus R will give me the R of B point. So if R of HPC is not, then the R of B will be that R of HPC plus B minus R. This will give us the RL of B. If suppose the RL of HPC is not given, but the RL of IS is given. If the RL of IS is given and I have asked to calculate the RL of B, what I have to do? I am at this position. The RL of this point is given. RL of this point is given. What I have to do? The RL of IS plus H, always at the horizontal plane of collimation, and then we will do the same thing that if we have reached this position, then we will add the V to this, so we will reach at this position, then subtract the R. So we will reach at this position the RL of V. So if RL of IS is given, then what we have to do? The RL of IS plus H, we will get this position, then R, then plus V, and then minus R. So in another way, we can write it. The RL of IS, the IS is nothing but instrument illustration plus H. This will give us the RL of HPC, then the rest of them will remain same. Plus V minus R. This is nothing but the RL of this is all about the case 1. That is what the both angles are angle of elevation. We calculated the formula for D, that is D equals to S divided by tan theta 1 minus tan theta 2. Here we can remember that theta 1 is a bigger angle, theta 1 is the angle corresponding to the upper bend, right? The theta 2 is the angle corresponding to the lower bend. So S divided by tan of angle corresponding to upper bend minus tan of angle corresponding to bottom bend. That will give us the distance of station B from the instrument station. Let's move to the case 2, that is both the angles are angle of depression. Let's call this as point Q. Let's call this point as K. So here in this case, the distance between this P and Q, this will be the stop intercept. Y, the distance from B to this lower bend, this will be the R. Let's call this as R. And this from Y to the collimation, this distance will be the distance V. And let's call that angle corresponding to this. This is the theta 1, while the angle corresponding to this lower band, this is called as theta 2. So this is given to us. So we know that this is the angle, this will be the right angle here. This is the what? The angle of, this is what the case to the both angles are angle of depression. This is the point, let's call this point as point A, where the instrument is kept. Let's adjust the formula. We can see that, let's call this point as that triangle O, Q, K, or the triangle O, K, Q, from triangle O, K, Q, the triangle O, K, Q is a right angle triangle. In this triangle, we will apply for tan theta 1. So, tan theta 1 in a right angle triangle, this tan theta 1 will be, in O, K, Q, this angle, the overall angle is theta 2. So, let's take tan theta 2 in this angle, triangle O, K, Q. So, the angle met by the lower band, it is theta 2. So the tan theta 2, it will be the kq divided this kq divided by this ok. While this distance from O to K, this will be the distance D. So from here, the KQ will be this K, this 2Q, this KQ will be this will be V minus R. Sorry, the V will be this much. Up to this point, this will be the V point. So the KQ, this is the KQ. So the, we are interested to find out the KQ. So the KQ will be the V only. This V divided by the OK. The OK is nothing but the D. So from here we got that V equals to D tan theta 2. Let's call this as equation number 1. Now we have solved this for this triangle, that is OK and Q. Now let's solve for triangle OKP. OKP. So from triangle OK and P, the triangle OKP is also a rectangle triangle. So from here the angle made by this above end, this is the theta 1. So tan theta 1 equals to this tan theta 1 will be, this will be the PK divided by the OK. This PK, this is the PK, so this is this much distance. I can write this PK as V minus S. This top overall is not to as this overall is not us as a V. After this, this PQ is nothing but S. So I can write this PK as KQ minus PQ divided by OK. KQ minus PQ, this, so this will be the V minus S divided by D. So from here I can write that V minus S equals to D tan theta 1. Let's call it as equation number 2. If you apply the operation that equation number in the equation number 1 minus equation number 2. If I do this, then it will be the V minus V plus S equals to d tan theta 2 minus d tan theta 1. Here we do will get cancer, only s will be left out, as well as on the right hand side we can take the ds common, so it will become tan theta 2 minus tan theta 1. Instruments I, the I of I s plus s, so I will write it in a proper way only. Case 3 is one angle is angle of elevation, y, the other angle is the angle of depression. Let's call this point as a P, this point as a Q, this point as a K, this is a point O, this is the instrument station, let's call this point as A, then this will be the instrument height, the height H, and so let's call this the point B, so this will be the sharp intercept, distance between P and Q. Well, this will be your R and this distance will be the V, the QK. This will be the V. This is the V. This point from P to Q is the R. I have the distance between the elevation between P and Q. This will be the sharp intercept, that is S. This point is K. Now, here it is what? The one angle is angle of elevation. Let's call this angle as theta 1. While this angle is, let's call this as theta 2. So here we can see that the triangle OP and K, the triangle OP and K is a right angle triangle. So from triangle OP and K, from triangle OPK, I can write that tan theta 1 equals to, tan theta 1 equals to, this will be the PK divided by this OK. And OK is nothing but it will be the D. I will mention just here. Or I'll write this to this side better now. This distance is nothing but the D. So here the PK divided by OK. So PK will be, if I can want to write the PK, this is the PK, So it is PK, I can write the PK, the PQ minus KQ. The PQ minus KQ will give me the PK. So what is the PQ? The PQ is nothing but the S minus QK. QK is nothing but the V divided by OK is D. I write this in the form of that S minus V equals to D and theta 1. Let's call this as equation number 1. Now we have analyzed for the triangle OP and K. The OPK is also right in the triangle. Now we will analyze the triangle OK and Q. The triangle from triangle OKQ or OQK, we can write anything. It's right angle triangle, so here the tan theta 2, this tan theta 2, this will be the tan theta 2 will be the KQ divided by OK. It will be KQ divided by OK. the KQ, this distance KQ, this is nothing but the V. So this will be the V divided by OK number D. So from here we will get that V equals to D and theta 2. Let's call this as equation number 2. I got this D equal to D tan theta 2. This is F minus V D tan theta 1. If I add the equation number 1 and equation number 2, the term V to V will get cancelled and I'll get the answer. I'll get the equation in the form of, in terms of S, D and theta tan theta 1 and theta 2. So we'll apply the operation from, just add equation number 1 and equation number 2. From equation number 1 plus equation number 2, if I add both the equation, what it will be? It will be the S minus V plus V. This is what the left hand side, S minus V plus V, we are adding these two equations, equation number 1 and equation number 2. The right hand side, it will be D tan theta 1 plus D tan theta 2. This V to V will get cancelled. So from here, if I take the D from here common, I will get in bracket tan theta 1 plus tan theta 2. So from here, I can write that D equals to S divided by tan theta 1 plus tan theta 2. This is the formula for D. Here again, if RL of HPC, if again here the RL of HPC is known to us, this level is known to us, and we want to reach at this level, simply what we will do, the RL of HPC minus V minus R. This will give us the RL of V. Minus V. Minus R. We are at this position, this is given to us, the RL of HPC is given to us. We are supposed to find out the RL of V. What I will do, I will subtract the V and R from the RL of HPC. So we will reach at this place of RL of V. So there are three cases in the dilution method. So we have seen the three cases. The case 1, the one angle is angle of, what the angle are? Angle of elevation, that is case 1. And then we have seen the case, we saw the case 2, that is both angle are angle of depression, and then this is the last one, that is one angle is angle of elevation and another one is angle of depression. Let's solve some of the example on this. First we will write what is given data. What is given to us in this? What is the question? Let's read the question first. That in the tangential method of trichometry, two vents were placed at an interval of 1 meter on a 3 meter staff with the bottom vent at 1 meter. The staff was held, held vertical at a station A and vertical angles measured for two vents were 5 degree 30 minutes and 3 degree 15 minutes respectively. We are asked to find out the reduced level of point A as well as the horizontal distance of A from the instrument station, and the RL of HPC is given as 400 meter. So this falls as both the angles are given, the poising is the 5 degree 30 minutes as well as 3 degree 15 minutes. So this means what? The both angle are the angle of elevation. The question belongs to the case 1. So let's draw the figure first and then we will start solving the problem. This is given as 3 degree 15 minutes. This is the D. This we need to calculate. The angle of this point is given as 400 meter. what else is given? Two men's were fixed and an interval of 1 meter, that means this distance is given as 1 meter. There are two men, they are given at 1 meter. The 3 meters the stop height, while the bottom bend were at 1 meter, that means this R value, this is given as 1 meter, this is also given as 1 meter. Vertical angles are given 5 degree 30 minutes and 3 degree 15 minutes, and we are asked to find out the reduced level of point A. This point A where the staff is kept vertical, this is the instrument height, this is the instrument station, this has X, this is not required, this X calls point O. So we are asked to find out the R of this point also, if this point is given. So this distance will be called as D, this we have to find out. So we will start first, what is given? S is given, the stop intercept is 1 meter. Then second, the R is also given as 1 meter. Then the theta 1 and theta 2, theta 1 is 5 degree 30 minute, while the theta 2 is nothing but 3 degree 15 minutes. This is given to us. So first of all, we will try to find out the value of D. We have the direct formula. The problem belongs to the case when both the angles are angle of elevation. So for this formula will be D equals to S divided by 10. Angle corresponding to upper bend minus angle corresponding to lower bend. So it will be D 10 theta 1 minus D equals to S divided by 10 theta 1 minus 10 theta 2. S is known to us, this is nothing but 1 meter divided by 10, 5 degree, 30 minutes minus 10, 3 degree, 15 minutes. If we will solve this, we will get the directly D. D is nothing but 25.73. Now, the first part is solved. This we have calculated, the horizontal distance. This we have got. This we got as the 25.313. Now we want to find out another thing, that is the reduced level. For this, the area of this point is given as 400 meters. We want to reach at this location. What we do? The area of this HPC coordinate plus V. We will reach at this position. Then we will subtract this value R, that is 1 meter. So we can reach at the place A. But this is known to us, this is known to us, but D is not known to us. So what we will do? If we call this point as point O, let's call this as K, let's call this as Q. So in the triangle OKQ will be a rectangle triangle. So this 10, 3 degree 15 minutes, this will be V divided by D. So from triangle OQK. 10, 3 degree, 15 minutes equals to this QK. QK is nothing but the V. V divided by D. D was unknown earlier, but right now we have calculated the D, that is 25.313. So we will write it 25.313. So from here we will get the V. If we will solve this, then we will get the value of V as 1.47 meter. So now this is also known to us. This is 1.437 meter. Now we want to reach at this place. So what we will do? RL of A, nothing but the RL of HPC plus D minus R. The RL of HPC is given as 400 meter. We have calculated as 1.437 minus R. The value of R is given as 1 meter. So from here we will get is 400.437. This is the RL of point A. throughout this we were asked to find, and with this, these two we were asked to find. So we have calculated these two. Bar of this point is this one. This is what you have done. What we were asked? Let's see the question once again. What we were asked? In a tangential method of trigonometry, two waves were fixed at an interval of 1 meter on 3 meter stub with the bottom vane at 1 meter. The stub was held vertical at station A, and vertical angle measured for two vanes were 5° 30' and 3° 15' respectively. Find the induced level and horizontal distance of A. If the area of HBC is given as 400 meter, first of all we have calculated the horizontal distance D. From this we have directly used the formula. This problem, the problem belongs to case 1. That is D equals to S divided by tan theta 1 minus tan theta 2. So the S is given as 1 meter. Tan theta 1 and value of theta 1 and theta 2 is given to us. That is the vertical angles. So we have solved this equation. So we got the value of D, that is as 25.313 meters. Then from this triangle O, Q and K, we try to solve the value of B, that is 10 3° 15'. This will be the C divided by D. D we have already calculated as 25.313. The theta is 3° 15'. As we saw, we got the value of B as 1.437 meters. So the R of A will be the R of HBC plus B minus R. If we do this, we will reach at the position A. So we have done the same thing. 400 plus B, that is 1.437. And we have subtracted the R, that is 1. So we got the R of A as 400.437 meters. Let's take another problem. Question number 2, what is asked in this? Let's read the question first. In the tangential method of trigonometry, two vanes were fixed at an interval of 1.2 meter on a 3 meter stub with the bottom van at 1 meter. The stub was held vertical at the station A, and vertical angles measured for two vanes were 4° 30' and -3° 25' respectively. Find the reduced level and horizontal distance of A if the area of HBC is given, 450 meter. Here we can see in this case that this is the angle of elevation, right? This is the angle of depression, -3° 25'. So this problem belongs to the third case, when one angle is angle of elevation while another angle is angle of depression. So let's draw the figure for this first. This is the R of HBC, that is given as 450 meter. Apart from that, let's see what is given. The two vanes were fixed at an interval of 1.2 meter, means this is given as 1.2 meter. Right? This is the stub height is given 3 meter, the bottom vane were at 1 meter. So this is the point, this is bottom vane, this is given as 1 meter. This R, this is given as 1 meter. They are the angles, what are given? This is the positive angle, that is 4° 30', and this angle is the depression, that my negative just showing that is that its angle of depression, that is 3° 25'. These are given. We are asked to find out the distance, that is from this point to this. This D is asked to find out. And we are also asked to find out the RL of this point. If the RL of this point is given, then the RL of HBC is given. This is what we have asked. So let's write the given data first. What is given to us? The stub intercept is given as 1.2. So the first point 1.2, then second r is given as 1 meter. This is what given, that theta 1 4 degree 30 minutes, then theta 2 as 3 degree 25 minutes. Here I am not writing the negative because the only sign of negative is just at the end, that is angle of preparation. We have drawn the formula. There is no chance of confusion, so I am not writing the negative. If you are getting confused at initial level, you can write the theta equals to minus initially, but take care that while putting the value of theta in the formula, don't consider the negative. It does plus sign, plus and minus just represents the angle of elevation or depression. The plus represents the angle of elevation, while the negative represents the angle of depression. So this is what you are, and then the value of r is, and r of HPC is also given as, this is also given as 450 meter. So we will solve first the D. We will apply the formula directly. The problem belongs to the case 3, that is one angle is angle of elevation while the another angle is angle of depression. So this is nothing but D equals to F divided by tan theta 1 plus tan theta 2. So this will be the S is 1.2 divided by tan 4 degree 30 minute plus tan 3 degree 25 minutes. If I will solve this, then I will get the value for D as D equals to, this will be 8.67 meter. This is required as 8.67 meter. Now, this value is, this will be the V. This will be called as V. Now, so we have already calculated this horizontal distance. We have calculated this horizontal distance. This we got as 8.67 meter. Now, the second problem. Now, we need to find out the second problem. So, the second question is, that is the reduced level. The reduced level of this point A is asked, and the reduced level of HPC is given, that is 450 meter. So, what we can do? We are at this position right now. We need to reach at this position. So, what we will do? We will substitute the value of V and value of R, that is 1 meter. So 450 minus V minus this 1 meter will give me the RL of this point A. But the RL of this point B is not given. So what we will do? Let's call this point as Q. This O, Q and K, this is right angle triangle. So from here, we'll be using of tan theta, this tan 3 degree 25 minutes equals to this V divided by T. This will give us the value of V. So we will apply this from triangle, or you can directly, if you can remember the formula, whatever we have derived in case 3, if you can remember the formula, then directly you can use the formula also. But this is a better practice to solve, so there is no chance of committing the mistake. So in the triangle O, K, Q, this is a right angle triangle. So from here, the 10, 3 degree, 25 minutes, this will be nothing but the V divided by the T. This will be nothing but the V, this QK, that is V divided by T. D we have already calculated as 8.67 meter. So if we solve this, we will get the value of V as 0.517 meter. We got the value of V. We got this V as 0.517. Now we need to reach at this position. So similar to also, easily we will subtract these two values. The RL of A, this will be nothing but RL of HPC minus V minus R. So this will be 450 minus V, that is 0.517, minus R, that is 1 meter. So this will be 438.8 487 meter. This is what the RL of A. So we have prepared this. These two things are asked for us, the reduced level. So the reduced level of this point, what we got? The 438.487. This is what this was all about, this problem. In the tangential method of tachometry, two vanes were fixed at an interval of 1.1 meter on a 3 meter staff with a bottom variant 1 meter. The staff was at vertical at station A. The vertical angle measured for two vanes were -3° 25' and -4° 25' respectively. Find the reduced level and horizontal distance of A if the RL of HPC is given as 430 meter. This problem belongs to the case number 2 for the angle of depression. Let's show the figure first. This is what we want to find out. Distance D. We have given two angles. This is 4° 25', while this is 3° 25'. This will be the staff intercept. This value is R. And this is HPC, this is given as 430 meter. And this value will be known as, this height will be called as B. And this this is given to us as 430 meter, and we are asked to find this distance, this elevation. The elevation of point A, the RL of point A is asked to find us. So this is instrument station, yes, this point is point O. So this is point P, this is point Q, this is point K. So we will look at what is given to us. S is given in this problem. Two vanes were fixed at an interval of 1 meter. So this S, this is given as 1.1 meter. With bottom end at 1 meter, that means R is also given at 1 meter. Vertical angles for two vanes were 3° 25' and 4° 25'. The minus represents that both are the angle of depression, and we are asked to find the reduced level, that is this level RL of this point, and the horizontal distance, that is this distance T. So we will write this first of all. What is given? The first thing, the staff intercept is given as 1.1 meter. Second, the R is given as 1 meter. Then theta 1 and theta 2, 3° 25', and theta 2 as 4° 25'. This is given in RL of HPC. As for 30 minutes. So first of all, we will calculate the value for D, that is D equals to, we will apply the formula, that is D equals to S divided by 10 theta 2 minus 10 theta 1. So here it will be, S is given as 1.1 meter divided by 10 theta 2 is nothing but 4° 25'. Minus tan theta 1, that is tan 3 degree
25 minutes. If you will solve this, we will get the value of b directly, that is d equals to 62.73. This is what we got the d. Now, this is the d, this is what we find out the d, that is 62.73 meters. Now we are asked to find out the arc of this point, and the arc of this is given, the arc of HPC is given as 430 meter. What we have to do, the arc of HPC 430 minus B minus R. If we will do this, if we apply this operation, then we will reach at this level. So for that, the value of R is known to us as 1 meter, but the value of B is not known. So we have to calculate it. How we can calculate? In the triangle OK and B. The triangle OKP is a right angle triangle. So where the right seat from triangle O, K, P, and 4 degree 25 minutes equals to the V divided by D, that is 62.73. Where we are using this triangle OK and P, the triangle OK and P is the right angle triangle. So the angle is 4 degree 25 minutes, this tan of 4 degree 25 minutes, this will be this KP, KP is nothing but D divided by this base, that is the value of D. We have calculated in the previous step as 62.73. So from here we get the value of B directly, B will be 62.73 into tan 4 degree 25 minutes. If you will solve this value, you will get as 4.85 meter. Now we have got the value of B. We are at the last step. That is, we just need to apply some of the operation. What will be the R? What will be the R? The R of this is, that is 430 minus B minus R. So R of HPC is given as 430 meter minus V, that is 4.85 minus R is given as 1. A is 424.15. This was our final finding. So we have calculated the reduced level of A as well as the horizontal distance of D, that is point A, from the instrument station. So in this class we have learned the tangential method of trigonometry, and let us see what is tangential method of trigonometry, in what situation we can prefer it. Then we discuss the three cases under that, that is case 1, both the angles are angle of inclination, and then case 2, both the angles are angle of depression, and then case 3, one angle is angle of elevation and another angle is angle of depression, and we saw the numericals on that. So this covers the tangential method of trigonometry. This is all about this lecture.